माई डियर फ्रेंड्स, माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर राकेश कुमार त्रिपाठी एंड वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस रैशनलाइजेशन इन दिस वीडियो. सो वॉट इज रैशनलाइजेशन? सो यू वुड हैव सीन दैट वॉट काइंड ऑफ नंबर इज दिस रूट टू. रूट टू इज एन इरेशनल नंबर. रूट थ्री, वॉट काइंड ऑफ नंबर इज रूट थ्री? रूट थ्री इज इन एन इरेशनल नंबर. एंड वट इज रूट थ्री इंटू रूट थ्री? Root 3 into root 3, you know what is root 3 into root 3? Root 3 into root 3 is 3. Root 3 is what? Irrational number, irrational numbers, irrational number, but its outcome is what? A rational number. So in rationalization, suppose we have a denominator like this, 2 upon 7 plus root 2. So 7 plus root 2. What kind of number is this? This is an irrational number. But to convert this irrational number into a rational number and this expression remains an equivalent expression whose denominator is rational, whose denominator is what? Rational, and this numerator may be irrational. So such kind of equivalent expression in which denominator can be converted into a rational is called rationalization of denominator. And similarly, numerator can be rationalized, but in this video we will be discussing more on rationalizing denominator, more on rationalizing denominator. So to rationalize denominator, we should know some rules. So what are those rules? Let's see. Root A into root B. Root A into root B is what? Square root of A into square root of B is what? It is square root of A into B. But mind it, A and B, here A and B, in your case, A and B must be greater than or equal to 0. Even it both may be 0. I'll not discuss more on this issue here, but as far as class 9 is concerned, you keep this thing in mind. And similarly, root over A upon root over B is equal to root over A by B, where B is not 0, A and B both greater than 0. B is not 0. A may be 0. So I can write it separately. A may be 0, greater or equal to 0. But root A plus root B is not equal to root A plus B. We can understand this thing with an example. Root over 9 plus root over 16. Root over 9 is what? 3. Root over 16 is 4. And if I write root over 9 plus 16, which is 25, is what? 5. And you can see 3 plus 4 is not equal to 5. So it is not true. It is not true. So keep this in mind. And similarly, this is not true. So root A into root B is equal to root AB, and root A upon root B is equal to this much. And general identities you must be knowing. A square minus B square is what? A plus B into A minus B. But if I write A square minus B, then it can be written as A minus A square minus root B square. And if I apply the same, A minus root B into A plus root B. So it's a very simple multiplication you can see here. And A cube minus B cube, you must be knowing. A minus B, A square plus B square plus AB. and I made a video on this a cube minus b cube, how to find this value. That is a very interesting video. I request you to watch that video. And similarly, few more identities like a cube plus b cube, a plus b, a square minus ab plus b square. All these kind of identities you will have to keep in mind. Law of indices. You know very well. What are they? A to the power m into a to the power n is what? A to the power m plus n. A to the power m upon a to the power n is what? A to the power m minus n. A to the power m whole to the power n is a to the power m into n. Not same as. Keep this thing in mind. Very interesting thing I am discussing with you people. A to the power m to the power. These two are not same. And for this, I quote an example. This is a very important property. Keep this thing in mind. 2 to the power 3 square whole 2. 2 to the power 3 to the power 2. Let's understand the difference. What is this? This is 2 to the power 3 into 2 to the power 3. So what is this? This is 2 to the power 6. And what about this? This is what? This is 2 to the power 3 square times. 2 to the power 3 square means this is 2 to the power 9. So 2 to the power 9. And what is this? This is 2 to the power 6. So you can experience that these two are not same. So I request you to keep this property in your mind, and it's a very important property. You can note down in your diary or in your copy. And a to the power minus m, you know, 1 upon a to the power m. A to the power m into b to the power m, a into b to the power m. A to the power m upon b to the power n is same as a upon b whole to, sorry, m a upon b whole to the power m. 1 to the power m is clear to you, 1. X to the power 0 or a to the power 0 is 1. Again, a brainstorming thing I am giving to you. 0 into 0 is what? 0. What is 0 to the power 0? Search it. 0 to the power 0 is what? What is 0 to the power 0? So, to rationalize something means, suppose if I wish to rationalize denominator, in this case, I will have to convert this denominator, which is an irrational number, into a rational number. So to convert into a rational number, I will have to multiply it with root 2 and divide by root 2. So this becomes 1 into root 2. Root 2 into root 2 is root 2 square, and it is clear to you that this is 2. So it's equivalent fraction is this, equivalent to this is this, whose denominator is what? Whose denominator is a rational number. So this procedure of rationalization we can apply for few more complex numbers, means for few more complex cases like 2 upon a root 5 plus 4. Suppose if I wish to rationalize it, means rationalize its denominator, to remove this irrational number by rational numbers, what shall I have to do? I shall have to multiply both numerator and denominator by this kind of number, so that it becomes 2 into root 5 minus 4 upon a plus b into a minus b. So root 5 square minus 4 square. Root, we can multiply, if we wish to multiply, 2 into root 5 minus 2, 4 is 8. Root 5 square is 5 minus 4 square is minus 16. 5 minus 16 is clear to you. 2 root 5 minus 8. 5 minus 16 is minus 11. If we wish to remove this minus, we can take minus common from numerator. 8 minus 2 root 5 upon minus 11. Minus minus get cancelled. This is the equivalent form, equivalent number to this number, to the given number, whose denominator is a rational number now. Earlier it was an irrational number, because rational plus rational, rational plus rational, keep this thing in mind, very important thing. You can note in your diary, rational number plus rational is a rational number. Rational plus rational is a rational. Similarly, rational minus rational, rational. Irrational plus rational, irrational plus rational is an irrational number. Irrational plus rational is an irrational number. Irrational plus irrational will be what? May be an irrational, may be a rational, like root 3, irrational root 3, and if I add minus root 3 to this, irrational, and what is this? Irrational. But its outcome is 0, which is a rational number. So irrational plus irrational, I am not guaranteeing. Irrational plus irrational may be irrational, may be rational. But irrational plus rational is what you can see, irrational. And rational into irrational, irrational into a rational, or rational into irrational is again irrational. But rational should not be zero, because if you multiply root 3 with 0, root 3 into 0 is 0, and 0 is what? 0 is a rational number. So keep this thing in mind. So irrational into rational is irrational, irrational plus rational, irrational, rational plus minus rational is rational. So its denominator is what? Irrational. Now I have reduced this number into an equivalent form, and in that form denominator is not an irrational number, now it is a rational number. Similarly, let's discuss few more problems of rationalization. In which you may be asked question like this: if a plus b root 3 is equal to 2 plus root 3 upon 2 minus root 3, if this is a question I am discussing. If a plus b root 3 is equal to this much, then find a and b. Or sometimes you may ask, then find a and b. Or sometimes you may ask, find a plus b or a minus b, whatsoever it is. So first of all, what we shall have to do, we shall have to rationalize denominator, and then let us see. So to rationalize this, we shall use the most appropriate number which should be multiplied and divided, so that this irrational number can be converted into a rational number. So the best number is 2 plus root 3. So multiplying and dividing both numerator and denominator by 2 plus root 3, numerator becomes 2 plus root 3 whole square, and denominator you can see 2 square minus root 3 square. Expand it, 2 square plus root 3 square plus 2 into a into b, a square b square 2ab. I am using that formula. And you know, in denominator I used a minus b into a plus b. What is that? A minus b into a plus b, a square minus b square. So 2 square is 4, root 3 square is 3. 2 square is what? 4. Root 3 square is 3. 2 plus 2, 2 into 2, 4. 4 into root 3 is 4 root 3. And denominator is 4 minus 3, that is 1. And if 1 is in denominator, no need to write it. 4 plus 3 is 7, and plus 4 root 3. What is this? This is a plus b root 3. Now we can compare both sides. What is a? A is 7. And what is b? So this implies a is equal to 7 and b is equal to 4. And suppose if I wish to find what is a plus b, so a plus b will be 7 plus 4, 11. So in this way we can rationalize this kind of expressions, and you can evaluate values of a and b. I am assigning you a question like this: a plus b root 3 is equal to 2 minus root 3 upon 2 plus root 3, and you are supposed to find a minus b in this case. And one more, to simplify, 3 plus root 5 upon 3 minus root 5 plus 3 minus root 5 upon 3 plus root 5. Two options I am suggesting you. You rationalize firstly denominator of this and denominator of this separately, and then add. And another option, the second option, take LCM and then evaluate, and you will get the same answer. So my best wishes with you. Do practice more and keep in touch. Wish you all the best.